Hi children, welcome back. Today we are going to learn about geography first chapter, that is resources. Students, at the end of this chapter you will be able to learn what is a resource, types of resource and conservation of resources. First of all, let us know what is the meaning of a resource. Anything that satisfies a need is a resource. The water we drink, the books we read, or the transport which you use to come to school. All the things which we use have utility or usability. We use them according to our needs. How does something become a resource, children? Yes. It is utility makes an object into a resource. Its use or utility gives it a value. So, all the resources have some value. Some resources are economically valuable, whereas some do not have. For example, the precious metals like gold having some economical value, whereas a beautiful scene does not have an economic value. Time and technology are two important factors that can change substances into resources. For example, you take a raw material. That raw material, by using technology, it takes some time to become a resource. Likewise, people, they educate themselves, they gain some skills and they also become a resource. So people themselves are also most important resource. Come, let us know about the types of resources. Resources are classified into natural, human-made and human. First we'll discuss about natural resources. These are the resources which are drawn from nature and used without much modification. Those are called natural resources. Let us see the pictures. The air we breathe, the water we drink, the plants, the coal, these are all natural resources which we obtain from the nature. These natural resources are classified into different groups. Here we see three different groups. That is the first one, the level of development and use. On the basis of development and use. On the basis of origin. On the basis of stock and distribution. On the basis of the development and use, resources are classified into actual and potential resources. Actual resources. These are those resources whose quantity is known and being used in the present. At present we are using them. For example, the rich deposits of coal in Ur region of Germany, petroleum in the West Asia, the dark soils of the Deccan Plateau in Maharashtra. Now comes to potential resources. These are those resources whose entire quantity may not be known and these are not being used at present. Because we don't know their quantity and quality, that is why we are not using. These could be used in the future. For example, Rajasthan and Gujarat, they have enormous energy of solar energy, but we are not using at present. Because the hydro power and the thermal power cost is less when compared to solar energy. Maybe in the future we may use them. Here the textbook, they gave the example uranium. Uranium found in the Ladakh is an example of potential resources because we are not using that at present. Biotic. On the basis of origin, resources are classified into biotic and abiotic. Abiotic things. Abiotic things are resources. They are non-living things. It means they does not have life. biotic things are living things, they have life. So here we see the example of the non-living things, soils and rocks. Biotic things, plants and animals, etc. Natural resources, renewable and non-renewable resources. In this renewable resources, these are those resources which get renewed or replenished quickly. Some of these are unlimited, they're available unlimited in quantity and are not affected by human activities. For example, solar energy and wind energy. But careless use of certain renewable resources like water, soil and forest can affect their stock. Non-renewable resources are those which have limited stock. It may take thousands of years to be renewed. Example, coal, petroleum and natural gas. They get complete after their use. So it takes some thousands of years for their formation. On the basis of the distribution of resources, resources can be classified into two, ubiquitous or localized. Resources that are found everywhere, like the air we breathe, are ubiquitous because air is everywhere. But those which are found only in certain places are localized resources. For example, copper and black soil. Iron ore also. These are the resources which will be found in some certain places only. So, the distribution of natural resources depends upon number of physical factors like terrain, climate and altitude. All the things which we use have utility or usability. We use them according to our needs. How does something become a resource, children? Yes. It is utility makes an object into a resource. Its use or utility gives it a value. So, all the resources have some value. Human resources. People can make the best use of resource to create more resources because it is we with our knowledge, skill and technology, we do so, we convert the things into resources. That is why human beings are a special resource. People are the human resources. Now you are students, you receive education and gain your knowledge and skill. Tomorrow you become the human resource. Education and health help in making people a very valuable resource, improving the quality of people's skills so that they're able to create more resources. That is known as human resource development. Conserving resources. Using resources carefully and giving them time to get renewed is called resource conservation. If you sow a sapling, it takes 5 or 6 years to become into an adult tree. So in this way, the tree or the plant get renewed in over time. Sustainable development is, it is nothing but balancing the need to use resources and also conserve them. It means you need to use the things in a balanced way and conserve them for which purpose, for the future's sake. That is called sustainable development. Here are some of the ways of conserving resources. See here the given 3 R's, reuse, reduce and recycle. It means we should use again and again the resources. That's called reuse, reduce. We should reduce the use of the resources. Next one, the recycled ones. For example, plastic, iron and some important metals, we'll recycle them. In that way, we can conserve our resources up to some extent. Because we are not using that at present. Biotic on bio